Hi, I'm Nikita, and you're watching Prepfully's Amazon Business Intelligence Engineer interview guide. In this video, we will discuss the format of the interview and dive into how you can tackle the various rounds that come your way. At Prepfully, we offer mock interviews with someone who's worked at your target company and role. We also offer interview guides, interview questions and answers, and packages. The Amazon BI Engineer interview process consists of a total of 6 to 7 interviews that are conducted across 3 rounds. The first 2 rounds are typically over a call or video after the recruiter has approached you via email. The first phone screen will have a mix of technical and behavioral questions. The second will be with the hiring manager and will majorly focus on leadership-oriented questions. The third and final round is the on-site round, which will consist of 5 interviews with various executives of the company. 2 of these will have a mix of technical and behavioral questions again, and 3 would be purely behavioral, focusing on Amazon's 14 leadership skills. Let's discuss these rounds in detail. For each round, we will discuss what kind of questions are asked and some tips that will help you answer these questions. The first screening process is the 40-minute phone screen, which will consist of a mix of 5 to 6 behavioral and technical questions. SQL, also known as SQL, is a commonly assessed topic in this round, and you can expect questions on concepts of data modeling, data warehousing, and data engineering. Through this round, the interviewer will assess your coding skills and your approach towards a problem, and through the behavioral questions, they will conclude if you're a cultural fit for the company. During this interview, you will be asked to write queries in a text editor, but you won't be able to execute them and check for errors or debug them. Therefore, we recommend that you get lots of practice on writing syntactically correct queries. Since SQL forms a major proportion of the interview questions, get your basics right. You should be very familiar with fundamentals such as joins, the where clause, group by, and case. It has also been observed that interviewers tend to look out for candidates who are proficient in Python, so revise your Python concepts as well. For all coding questions, don't dive straight into writing the code. Talk to the interviewer about what the problem demands and how you will approach it, and then move on to the coding. These tips will help you walk through this round with ease. You should also note here that the choice of database in this round is flexible. You can use Oracle, MySQL, or any other database that you're comfortable with. Next up is the second round, which is the hiring manager phone screen. This round focuses more on behavioral and leadership-oriented questions. However, 2-3 basic technical questions may also be asked, so be prepared. You may also be given a business case study and be asked to provide your insights on it. This round gives the interviewer a glimpse into your personality, how you've handled work situations in the past, and whether you're a good candidate for Amazon. The behavioral questions usually follow the format of tell me about a time when, where you'll have to describe a scenario that you faced, similar to that given in the question. A couple of popular behavioral questions reported by recent Prepfully candidates are 1. Tell me about a time you made a decision without consulting your manager. And 2. Tell me a situation where you made a big mistake that cost the company. What did you do? A couple of technical questions that have recently been asked. 1. What is the difference between snowflake schema and star schema? And 2. How would you calculate week-on-week change in revenue using Tableau? To know more about such questions, make sure to check out Prepfully's question bank, which will give you an exhaustive list of questions to practice for each round. If you feel you're ready for the interview, give a mock test with Amazon experts at Prepfully and assess your preparation level. The link for both of these is in the description below. For this round, we also recommend that you follow the STAR methodology for answering the questions. STAR expands into situation, task, action, and result. So a typical answer explained in the STAR format would start with an explanation of the situation, move to the task at hand, and what action was taken. This is followed by the result, which explains what happened after the situation was handled. Focus on the process and the result, because that is essentially what the interviewer wants to know. Now we move on to the last and final round of the Amazon BI Engineer interview process, which is the on-site round. This is a 6-hour process, which consists of 5 interviews. For 4 of these, you will be talking to business intelligence engineers, hiring managers, business analysts, and data scientists. The last interviewer will be the Amazon Bar Raiser round, which will be conducted by an executive outside of the team that you're interviewing for. Each interview will be around 60 minutes long, with 50 minutes for the assessment part and 10 minutes for interacting with the interviewer. For the technical rounds, you will be tested on topics such as SQL, data visualization, data warehousing, ETL, descriptive analysis, and statistical analysis. For the behavioral rounds, make sure to prepare many different scenarios based on Amazon's leadership principles and how they link to your past experience, as they will be asked in all these rounds. Let's delve deeper into these 5 interviews one by one. The first interview will be with the hiring manager, which will just be composed of leadership questions. You can expect questions such as, tell me about yourself, why this role, tell me about a time when you anticipated a customer need and impressed them with your foresight. Again, we recommend that you follow the STAR method framework for answering these as well, as discussed before. The second interview will be with a business intelligence engineer, and and you will be asked both behavioral and technical questions. Some technical questions that have been asked previously are: 1. Given details about sales of product, how would you decide which product to price cut to improve the sales? And 2. What is a foreign key relationship? You can also expect some questions based on SQL. Some leadership-oriented questions that have been asked in this interview are: 1. Tell me about a time when you moved forward without your manager's approval. And 2. How did you solve a complex problem with a simple fix? Now, we move on to the third interview, which will be with a business intelligence analyst. This will be a purely technical round, and questions will mostly revolve around SQL, data modeling, data warehousing, and related concepts. Questions such as, how will you explain primary key and SQL joins to someone from a non-technical background? And what will you do if you identify slow-running queries in the SQL server are quite popular in this round. The bar raiser round is the fourth interview in the onsite round. This interview is unique to Amazon, and it is an extremely important stage in their assessment process. The interviewer examines how you influence your peers, deal with situations at work, and whether you're a potential fit for the company. You will also be asked a lot of follow-up questions based on feedback from previous interviewers so that they can truly dig into your experiences. Some questions that have been asked before are: 1. Describe a time when you were disappointed with a product's quality at work and went out of your way to change it. And 2. If there is a project that you're working on for the first time, how would you verify that the data is valid? The final interview in the onsite round is the data scientist round. This round again will have a mix of both technical and behavioral questions. The goal of this round is to ensure that you have the raw technical and management skills to succeed in this role. A couple of commonly asked behavioral questions would be: how do you test your work and measure your success? And how would you handle a disagreement with your manager? A couple of technical questions usually asked are similar to: design a data model for a school, and how will you predict the success or failure of a newly launched product? An important point you should keep in mind is that quantifying answers always makes them more authentic. So when possible, try to throw in a few numbers. This brings us to the end of this video guide. Check out the description for more material related to the Amazon Business Intelligence Engineer interview, such as sample interview questions, mock interviews, and other information that we've collated for you. We hope that this guide helps and that you ace your interview. Best of luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.